Hey guys, welcome to my vlog. Welcome to the vlog. Oh my gosh, I look a mess. I'm watching The Real Housewives. Yeah, so today Raj is coming over. That's the guy I was telling you guys about, who I went out with last night. He's coming over again. He apologized multiple times for the way that he was acting, and he's coming over today in the afternoon. We're just gonna hang out, watch movies all day, and do homework and stuff. So yeah, that's what I'm doing. I'm about to go put some makeup on. I'm gonna check up on the assignments, see what I did bad in, because y'all know I be doing bad in my homework. I'm so bad. I need to turn off the air conditioning. It's really chilly in here. Ooh, I had it on 70. I finally broke out the shoes. And now I'm looking, I'm like, bitch, you could have got rid of more shit than that. I don't know, I feel like I should move this. I kind of want to move it to like the room or something. I feel like it's good in here. I feel like it's good. I don't know. But I do want to move my TV to by the window. I'm just like flustered. I just got this wig today. Some Eva's wigs. And it's just not what I thought. It's like super thick. Super thick. And I don't know. Kind of annoyed. But I'm going to fix it. You never know what companies, like, sometimes when they send me wigs, like, the yaki hair is so thin, and then it's always, or it's just way too thick, and this one's, like, super thick, so, oh, we're gonna see. Hey, guys, so I just got back home. Well, I got back home about 40 minutes ago. He just left, and, well, he left 40 minutes ago. He took me, we went to McDonald's, but he bought me Chick-fil-A earlier, so that was really, really nice. The nearest Chick-fil-A is pretty far. So, yeah, and then we finally kissed today. Not finally, like we had our first kiss. That was interesting. I don't know. I know like I'm like moving forward, but I'm still like, I'm still trying to figure things out. I don't know. Like, it was one of those unexpected kisses. Like, he just came out of nowhere and he just, like, kissed me. And I hate when guys do that. I told him not to do that yesterday. I was like, do not kiss me. And he keeps feeling like the feeling is right. I don't understand, guys. Like, that is super, like, unconsensual, in my opinion. I'm just like, I don't know. There are just some people who are still getting on the bandwagon of consent. They don't get it. Like, anyway, there's just something not right. I can't put my finger on it. Like, I'm not feeling it. I'm not feeling a spark because I feel like this just isn't, like, real. I feel like, I don't know. I feel like he's just doing anything to have sex with me. So, that makes me not want to have sex. I kind of don't even want to. Like, I know what I want. And I feel like, this is such a bad angle. This one's not that better, but it's better. I don't know. I just feel like I know what I want, and he's not it. I feel like I need... But the thing about it, guys, is that I've never had, like, butterflies for anybody. I've never, like... I've had butterflies after the fact that we broke up. Like, you know, I saw the person, it was just like, oh, my gosh, you know. Because I knew what I didn't really have. Because it's not like... Okay, you know, it's weird. Like, when you're in a relationship, like, it's not that you didn't think that it's like you just never thought you would lose the person. So it's not, I knew what I had, maybe like not that much, but you know what I'm saying? Like, I know a lot of people say, oh, you just whatever. So yeah, I haven't had butterflies for anybody. Like, I do get nervous meeting people, but there's a difference between butterflies and getting nervous. Now, I'm not gonna lie, when he texted me earlier today, like, I did get kind of excited. So I guess that can count, but I don't know if I'm just excited because I just haven't been in a real relationship in so long where somebody took me out, they were taking out the time with me. It's been a really long time, guys, so I don't know if that's what it is. And that's just not real. And I'm not like, so I'm having kind of like a hard time, you know, just kind of like being with him because I just feel like I'm just, I'm just with him because I'm bored. Okay, I need to get another napkin because this one is all messed up. Get the rest of this crap off my face. Okay, even worse, guys, like, I almost feel like I'm just using him for food. Like, I hate to even say that, but, like, I really liked him, but then he just kept trying to get, like, sexual, and he's always trying to get sexual, and it's like, okay, it's obvious that you just want sex, and we're just not looking for the same thing. Like, I'm just not looking for that, you know? I was telling you guys this yesterday, so now it's kind of just turned into me doing what I always do. Whenever I just not interested in a guy anymore, I just end up using him, and I just don't want to use anybody. Like, I think I'm just gonna have to end it. And I know that all of this sounds crazy, but that's just what happens. Kind of like when a guy is just like not interested in a girl anymore, so he sees that he can just use her for sex because that's available, so he just starts using her for sex, and then he just becomes like uninterested, and that's just what's happening. Like, we've only been talking for like a day, and I'm just like kind of like like him being so acting so desperate for sex, it just makes him like unattractive to me. So yeah, I'm probably just gonna end up ending it. I mean, I did tell him, but I think I'm just gonna stop talking to him. Like, I told him that, like, him, he keeps asking me, like, what do I think about him, like, do I like him? And I'm like, I like you, but I keep telling him, like, you act so desperate for sex. He's like, I'm not desperate. I'm like, but you're acting like you're desperate. And when it walks, quacks, and talks like a fucking duck, it's a duck. You're desperate. Like, stop fucking calling it. I'm calling you out. I'm telling you what you're doing. So just stop. If he doesn't stop, I'm going to stop talking to him. Or we don't need to be spending no more time together so I can just show him that I'm, like, serious. Because food is not that serious. I can always just walk to the grocery store. I can always walk and go give me something to eat. Like, there are actual food places that I would eat at where I live at right now. So, you know, it's different. Okay, I feel like this one took off, like, all the remaining makeup that I had on. Anyway, I'm going to go back and go sit down and edit some videos and see if there's any more homework due. I do have a test in a few days, though. So, I just did a treatment on my face. I used the whole Glam Glow products, and I'm on day two of taking my vitamins and stuff. I am really trying to get my skin back into check. Like, I don't know why this always happens to me every few months. Like, I let my period get the best of me. Look at my eyebrows. One is higher than the other. My entire face is, like, so completely off-centered. It's crazy. Like, see how this one is? This one should kind of be, like, that one or something. I don't know if it's, like, just, like, the hairs. Maybe it's all in my head. It could be all in my head. Anyway, I have on a face mask, but this one's like the greasy one. I'm going to wash it off in like a couple minutes. But yeah, I'm just editing some videos. Now I'm like for real about to go to bed. It's almost midnight. It's 5 minutes to midnight. And I just edited like three videos. I edited three videos today, and then I posted two of them today. But I'm really hoping that, like, with the combination of me taking care of my skin, drinking more water, and taking these pills, and my skin kind of, like, goes back to the way it was. It looks really bad, like, for real bad. My body skin is getting a little bit better. Maybe because I've been shaving lately, and when you shave, it exfoliates your body. I don't know. Anyway, guys, I love you so much. Have a good night. Bye. Good morning, guys. My mom is here. She's outside. She's over there getting off of my balcony. I'm too scared to do it. I'm a big baby. Okay, we're gonna go. She rented a car for the weekend. And I feel like I should have did a red lip today. I'm gonna bring a red lip with me. My mom rented a car for the weekend. I just did like a kind of like a pink nudie lip. And I'm kind of like taking a break from the makeup. I'll show you guys my face better in the light. Okay, I got my glasses. I got a phone charger. Oik! Let's see. My computer's charged. I need to put on some deodorant. I got my glasses. Oh, I need to bring my portable charger. You know what? I should just bring this whole bag. But I was worried that this bag was, like, too dirty at the bottom. Because when I was moving, my apartment was so dusty that, like, all my purses were really dusty. And I had to wash some of them. And this one was kind of dusty at the bottom. Even though I thought I had washed it, but apparently not good enough.
Hey guys, this is like a better look at my skin.
don't know how I'm getting like these whoops and stuff. But, like, my skin is like really struggling and it's really greasy right now. It's greasy because I just slathered cocoa butter like all over it. Cause I'm not sure if I'm like dry, if I'm like super oily. I don't have oily skin. My skin is extremely, extremely dry. So I'm not really sure what's going on. I know this guy is probably gonna come over to the car. Come talk to me, please. Hello. Yeah. Thank you. No, leave me alone. Hi. Thank you. Thank you so much. No. Mm-hmm. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Yeah. Okay, so my mom is in the doctor's office right now. She has something going on. Okay, for a second I was like, is that hair? So me and that guy, I don't know if he's homeless or if he's just like hanging out here. I don't know if he's waiting for his ride, but he was asking me if I had money so he could go to HEB. I actually really don't have any money. I have like no cash on me. So yeah, today I'm supposed to be hanging out with the Indian guy, but I'm not gonna hang out with him today. I have so much homework to do, and he's studying. He has like a lot of biology homework, and I'm just not in the mood. Like, I'm not in the mood to fight off predators. No, I'm just kidding. But yeah, I don't know. I think we're gonna go to Shalosky's Deli because I have a $5 coupon to there. I have to write this paper actually today. I'm really not even sure. So I think I told you guys, like, last night, this girl who we were supposed to be editing each other's papers, right? Which is cool. But, like, she didn't give me the paper till really late. But anyway, she just emailed me. She emailed my teacher and she was like, she knew I was late. And, like, you didn't give it to me till, like, 10:30 at night. I got home from the date at, like, 8:30. I took my shower. I did all my night stuff. She sent me half a paper to edit and she was like, she'll send me the rest later. That was at, like, 11 a.m. and I guess like almost 12 hours later she sends me the paper, and so I thought she was gonna send it to me before, but anyway, I told her I'm not gonna edit it. Anyway, I was just honest with her. I was like, okay, well, I'm not gonna edit it, you know. It wasn't even to be rude or anything. It's just that, like, I'm not even gonna do the assignment, so I'm not gonna edit it. You can edit it yourself. Like, or the teacher can or the teacher can just like sign you up for somebody else to edit it. So I'm just like, right now I'm trying to write this paper. It's worth 200 points, and if I could do good in this, like, I'll be like literally passing the class. Like, I mean, right now I have like a 69 in the class. I did really bad on my tests. Like, all my tests I got like a 60% on all of them. One test I got like a 70, and then another test I think I got like a 50. So I've been doing like real bad on them, so that's why I'm kind of like struggling right now. Let me see something. And then one assignment, I got a T. So turn, February 6th. Okay, good. Okay. I have one more thing to turn in this week. All of my foreign teachers, like, they're kind of rude. Like, I have one lady, she's a, I think she's like Middle Eastern or something, but she's kind of rude. Like, if you don't understand something, they get upset because you don't understand it. And it's like, and then my Spanish teacher also, like, they think that she's like, I don't understand what's going on. The Middle Eastern teacher, she's like, everybody else last semester got it, but this semester I've gotten so many. I'm like, she's saying I got so many emails that people are not understanding the assignment. Yeah, people are understanding it because it's fucking confusing. If half the class is telling you that they're confused and the other people are just winging it because they don't want to ask you, maybe something's not making sense. Like, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just like, whatever. All these teachers just get on my nerves because they're never like really making any sense. They really don't. Today is February the 2nd. What is today? Let me see. Today is the 2nd. Okay, so educational narrative. All right, that's gonna get turned in today. All my math work is done. My Spanish homework is due. I have
No, not to the 6th, so I'm good. All right, here we go. Ooh, nothing is due on the 4th and the 5th. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus.
I think I passed. Hey, guys. When we got Timmy Chan's in Houston, it is so delicious. Oh, my gosh. My mom is eating hers. I just Snapchatted. I always get the shrimp fried rice with wings. So they have it $5, 4 wings, small shrimp fried rice. Or you can get, like, a medium for $7. So, yeah, like, the total was, like, $16.
And a side order of...
And she gets a side order of green onion, so it can taste better.
I got my card right
here. Oh, Mom.